My dear learners, for this course on design of machine elements 2. In this module 2, we are discussing on design of springs. So far, we have solved 5 numerical problems on design of helical compressive spring with circular cross-section wire. Continuing our discussion on set 3 problems, the problem number 6 of our discussion states that a railway wagon weighing 50 kN and moving at a speed of 8 km per hour has to be stopped by 4 buffer springs in which the maximum compression allowed is 220 mm. Find the number of turns in each spring of mean diameter 150 mm. The diameter of spring wire is 25 mm. Take modulus of rigidity as 84 GPa. Also find shear stress. Let us solve this problem. If we list out the data given for problem number 6, we have a railway wagon weighing, so weight of railway wagon is given, which is 50 kN, moving at a speed of 8 km per hour. Velocity is known, 8 km per hour, has to be stopped by 4 buffer springs. So number of springs is given 4, in which the maximum compression, so maximum deflection is given as 220 mm. Find the number of turns. So I dash is asked of mean diameter, capital D is specified as 150 mm. Diameter of the wire is also specified, which is 25 mm. Take modulus of rigidity as 84 GPa. Also find shear stress. So this is the given problem. So the problem is like this. We have a railway wagon moving. So it has to be stopped by using 4 buffer springs. So since this wagon is moving with a velocity v, it possesses kinetic energy. So when this wagon comes and strikes this buffer springs, whatever kinetic energy stored in this wagon will be transferred to the spring. So therefore, kinetic energy of the wagon must be equal to the strain energy stored by the spring, or energy absorbed by the spring. So for equilibrium, whatever kinetic energy possessed by this wagon must be equal to the energy absorbed by the spring. Then only this wagon can be comes into rest. So therefore, for equilibrium, kinetic energy of wagon must be equal to energy absorbed by the spring. We know that kinetic energy is given by half mv square. This must be equal to energy absorbed by the spring. Whatever energy absorbed by the spring will be stored as strain energy. We know that strain energy of a spring is given by half kx square, where k is stiffness and x is deflection, which can also be written as half f into y, where f is force and y is deflection. This expression can be obtained by substituting stiffness is equal to force per deflection. Now we have 4 number of springs, so but we have to design for one spring, so hence consider the number of springs also. So whatever kinetic energy possessed by the wagon will be absorbed by 4 springs. You can see here, whatever kinetic energy possessed by the wagon will be absorbed by 4 springs. So now, substituting and solving, I will get, we can cancel off half and half here. So now, mass can be written as weight by acceleration due to gravity into v square. This is equal to f into y into number of springs. So substituting the values, weight is 50 kN, 15 × 10³, g is 9.81. If the velocity should be in meters per second, so therefore it is 8 × kilo means 10³. Hour to second is 3600 whole to the power of 2½ mv² is equal to f into maximum deflection allowed is 220 mm into number of springs is 4. So therefore load on each spring will be 2 meters per second, but here it is in millimeters, so therefore I should multiply it by 10⁻³. So therefore in meters this will be 0.22. Now the unit will match. So this is in kg, this is in meters per second, and this is in meters. Kindly make a note. So now you will get the answer as the load on each spring will be 28601.8 meters. So very important note is that velocity should be in meters per second and deflection should also be in meters, else this can be substituted as millimeters per second and I can substitute this in millimeters. Anyhow, we should match the units. So now I know F max, using which I can solve the problem. First thing is that I want to find the number of coils, so therefore use deflection equation, that is y max is equal to 8f d cube I divided by gd power 4. This is equation 11.5a. y max is known, 220, which is equal to 8 × 4 is known, 28601.8 into diameter is 150 cube into number of active coils divided by g is 84 × 10³ into small d, wire diameter is 25. So active number of coils will be 220 × 84 × 10³ × 25⁴ divided by 8 × 28601.8 × 150³. So active number of coils is 9.35, which is equal to 10 coils or 10 turns. Now from table 11.4 of page number 189, assuming square and grounded condition, you know that number of additional number of coils is 2, so therefore total number of coils I dash is equal to I plus N, which is equal to 12 coils. Next is also asked us to calculate the shear stress. We know that shear stress is equal to 8f dk by 5d³. This is equation 11.1b, where k is 4c minus 1 by 4c minus 4 plus 0.615 by c. This is equation 11.2a of our desired angle, where c is d by d, so which is 150 by 25, which is turning out to be 6. Next, k will be equal to, which is 1.2525. So therefore, the shear stress is 8 into force on each spring is 28,601.8 newtons, into diameter is 150, into K is 1.2525 divided by pi, into wire diameter is 25 cube. So therefore, the value of shear stress is 875.75 megapascals. So this is the solution for problem number 6. Let me pause this video for a while so that you people can copy it down. Later we will solve problem number 7. Next, going for problem number 7, a loaded narrow gauge car weighs 18 kN and moving at a velocity of 80 meters per minute is brought to rest by a buffer consists of two helical springs. In bringing car to rest, the spring undergoes a compression of 200 millimeters. The allowable shear stress is 0.3 gigapascals and the spring index is 8. Design the spring completely, take G as 84 gigapascals. So this problem is similar to problem number 6 which I solved, and since he is asking to solve or design the spring completely, we should repeat those 10 steps which I have already explained, which I clearly solved when I solved problem number 1 as well as problem number 5. So problem number 7 is the clubbed problem on problem number 6 plus problem number 5 or problem number 1. So let me explain what should be done. So if you consider problem number 7, the data given for problem number 7 is a loaded narrow gauge car weighs 18 kN moving with a velocity of 18 meters per minute is brought to rest by buffer consisting of two helical springs. So number of springs is 2. By doing so, the springs are compressed. Y max is 200 millimeters. The allowable shear stress is 300 megapascals. Spring index C is 8. Design the spring completely by taking G as 84 into 10 to the power of 3 megapascals. So this is similar to problem number 6. We have a car which is loaded and this car is moving with a velocity of 80 meters per minute. This is brought to rest by using two buffer springs. Now, for equilibrium, the kinetic energy of the car should be equal to the energy absorbed by the spring. So therefore, for equilibrium, kinetic energy of car should be equal to energy absorbed by spring. So kinetic energy of car is half mv square should be equal to half fy into number of springs, because we have more than one spring. The kinetic energy is absorbed by this combination of helical springs. So So now if I substitute, I can cancel half and half. Mass can be written as W by G into V square will be equal to F into Y into number of springs, that is 18 into 10 to the power of 3 divided by 9.81 into velocity is 18 meters per minute, meters per second whole square is equal to force is unknown. Deflection in meters will be 0.2, very very important, and the number of springs is 2. So therefore force on each spring F max will be, so force on each spring is 8154.9. So we know Y max 200 mm, we know F max 8155 newtons, and we know allowable stress, we know G, we know C. So therefore I can design this spring completely. I clearly explained how to design the helical compressive spring with circular cross sectioned wire, and also solved the complete design problem in problem number 1 as well as in problem number 5. Kindly revisit problem number 1 and problem number 5 and completely design yourself. If you completely design this problem, you will get the answers as in step 1 you will find the wire diameter. The standard wire diameter D for this problem should be 26 millimeters, and in step 2 we will calculate mean diameter, which will be 208 millimeters, and using deflection equation if you calculate active number of coils you will get 14. And for assuming square and grounded condition, if you calculate free length, free length should be greater than or equal to 666 millimeters. Coming for pitch, pitch is 43.86 mm, and coming for spring stiffness, F0 will be 40.775, and finally overall length will be 10,455.22. Total length of wire is 10,455.22 millimeters. So if you completely design, you should get these answers. Kindly do it yourself and check the answers what I gave. Let me pause this video for a while so that people can copy it down. Later we'll solve the final problem of this lecture. Now moving for problem number 8, states that a load of 2 kN is dropped axially on a closed coil helical spring from a height of 250 mm. The spring has 20 effective turns and it is made of 25 mm diameter wire. Find the maximum shear stress produced in the spring and the amount of compression produced. Take C is equal to 8 and G is equal to 84 gigapascals. So this problem is on impact loading. We have already studied in detail in our course on design of machine elements 1, that is designed for impact stresses. So we have a spring on which, if I list out the data for problem number 8, we have a spring we have a spring which is helical spring under compression with circular cross-sectioned wire, for which a load of W is falling axially from a height of 250 mm, which will cause compression. It is obvious that it will cause compression. Let us take it as maximum deflection. So now, if I list out the data given first, we have a load whose magnitude is 2000 newtons. It is falling from a height of 250 mm. The spring has 20 effective turns. So it is I, not I dash. It is I, 20 effective turns, that is active turns. And it is made of wire diameter as 25 millimeters. Find the maximum shear stress produced in the spring and the amount of compression produced, that is Y max. Take spring index as 8 and modulus of rigidity as 84 into 10 to the power of 3 megapascals. Now we have already know that the potential energy of a body is given by the formula MGH. For impact loading, we should take it as Mg into H plus Y, that is deflection. That is the condition for impact loading analysis. So, the potential energy of load, impact load, is given by Mg of H plus Y, which is nothing but work done by impact load. So, this can be written as Mg can be written as W of H plus Y. Now, for equilibrium, potential energy of load should be equal to energy absorbed by spring. So therefore, W times H plus Y should be equal to half Fy. So if I substitute and solve, W is known, which is 2000, H is known, which is 250, whereas Y is unknown. This is equal to half into, so force is unknown to us, and deflection Y is also not known to us. So therefore, if I solve, I'll get the equation as (4000 × 250), which is equal to 10 to the power of 6. So 10 to the power of 6 plus 4000 y is equal to Fy. Let us take it as equation number 1. Now we know that deflection is given by 8 f c cube i by g d. This is equation 11.5 a. So if I substitute, I get y is equal to 8 × f × c is 8 cube, effective number of turns is 20, divided by g is 84 × 10 to the power of 3, and wire diameter is 25 mm. So therefore, y is equal to 0.039 f take it as equation 2. Now if I substitute equation 2 in equation 1 and solve, I'll get the value of f. So substituting equation 2 in equation 1 and if I solve, I will get 0.039 f, 0.039 f into f is f square minus 4000 into 0.039. Is 156 f minus 10 to the power of 6 is equal to 0. So if I solve this, I will get the answer as, solving which I will get f max as, I will get the answer as f max is equal to 7444 newtons and minus 3444 newtons. So consider only positive value, so therefore I will get 7444 newtons as the answer. So I know f max. Now I can solve the problem. So now he has asked us to calculate the value of shear stress. So we know that tau is equal to 8f ck by pi d square. This is equation 11.1d, where k is 4c minus 1 by 4c minus 4 plus 0.615 by c. This is equation 11.2a. So therefore, if I substitute k as c is 8, so therefore k is, which is equal to 1.184. So therefore tau is 8 into 7444 into 8 into 1.184 by pi times wire diameter is 25 square. So therefore shear stress will be 8 into 7444 into 8 into 1.184 divided by pi into d square, which is 287.28 megapascals. And ultimately, coming for compression, we have y max is equal to 0.039 f. So using equation 2 itself, I can calculate the maximum deflection. So 0.039 into f is 7444, so it is turning out to be 290.316 millimeters. So this is the complete solution for problem number 8. So this completes our discussion on helical compressive spring with circular cross-sectioned wire. From next lecture, I will take up helical compressive spring with non-circular cross-sectioned wire, that is square and rectangular cross-sections. That's all from this lecture. Thank you all.